Nothing is more frustrating than destructive editing. Let me show you a few techniques to keep your Photoshop workflows non-destructive. Applying adjustments directly to your layers is just about as destructive as you can get. Instead of burning edits onto your pixels, like the sight of Comic Sans on a business card burns into your retinas, we can use adjustment layers, which can be added at the bottom of your layers panel. Here you'll find many of the same adjustments, but you'll notice that when one is selected, it's added as a separate layer with the adjustments available to edit within the Properties panel. The beauty of working with adjustment layers is not only can they be hidden or deleted at any point during your project, but many of the benefits of layers comes along with them. Want the adjustment to only affect the layer below? Hold down Alt or Option, hover in between, and click to clip. Need to remove parts of your adjustment? Use a layer mask. Grab your favorite brush and paint those areas into oblivion. Temporary oblivion, of course, since layer masks are also non-destructive. What now? What's this layer mask you speak of? Think of a layer mask as a non-destructive way to hide and show parts of your layers using black and white. And this is perfect for photo compositions. The Object Selection tool, amongst others, can be used to quickly isolate a subject. Then I suppose you could invert the selection and delete, but I can almost guarantee you're going to have nightmares about those missing pixels. So instead, applying a layer mask will keep everything inside your selection visible while hiding everything outside. And if you ever need to fine-tune your mask, grab a brush and paint away. Black to hide, white to reveal. Layer masks go a lot deeper than this, and I'll be sure to cover more in future videos. Filters are some of my favorite tools in Photoshop, but similar to adjustments, they can be very destructive if not applied correctly. For this photo, I'm going through and editing it using the Camera Raw filter, then jumping into Liquify for a bit of wacky fun. As each of these were applied, what did you notice? Yep, they were destructively applied directly to the image. Ugh. Instead, let's turn our image into a smart object, either by right-clicking on the layer, or by converting it under the filter menu. Now, what exactly happened here? I'll be diving deeper into smart objects in a future video, but essentially, the pixels of the original layer, or multiple layers in some cases, were just tucked away and preserved into a linked document, which can be accessed by double-clicking on the layer's thumbnail. Like adjustment layers, this brings along quite a few benefits. First, since the original layer is preserved, your smart objects can be resized down, then back up to its original size without introducing any unwanted pixelation. Second, on the topic of filters, take a look at what happens when I go through the process of using Camera Raw and Liquify again. Instead of that destructive nonsense from earlier, each filter is listed separately below the layer, allowing you to hide, delete, or even double-click to tweak later on. It even comes with its own mask, so you can hide portions of the filter if needed. Fancy! Sometimes you just want to get in, make a quick edit, and get on with your life. But for larger projects, you may want to ensure your touch-ups are reversible. Luckily, many of the healing tools can be used on new layers. The Spot Healing Brush, for example, has the ability to sample all layers, so each of your edits will be added to the active layer, rather than permanently burned onto the original. When using the Clone Stamp and Healing Brush, you can choose to sample the current layer, current and below, or all layers. This will help Photoshop understand what to look for and what to ignore when you hold down Alt or Option and click to create the sample. Finally, for larger areas, the infamous Content Aware Fill is a game changer. And if you're again working on a new layer, you can use the Content Aware Fill tool under the Edit menu. In addition to giving you more control over the selected and sampled areas, you can choose whether or not to sample all layers. No matter which healing method you use, working on a separate layer allows you to hide, delete, or fine-tune your edits so you're always working non-destructively. And those are just a few techniques to keep your Photoshop workflows non-destructive. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Definitely let me know in the comments what you'd like to see next. Follow me on Twitter, subscribe for more content, and I'll see you all next time.